Hello everyone. Today let us see how to prepare McDonald's style hash browns at home itself. The main ingredient over here, or the king of the recipe, is potato itself. Everybody will love this. This is the famous breakfast recipe. So why late? Let us start. Here I have taken medium sized potatoes, 8 in number. I have washed them and peeled them, and I have grated into a fine texture. See, like this. Into a long strands or thread like nature. Your potatoes peeled or grated should be in this texture. See the strangy nature or that thread type nature. So your potatoes grated should be of this kind. If you grate with the small holes from the grater, you will get your potatoes much watery. So just remember that. Now take a mixing bowl and place a sieve on that and add all the grated potato into it. This is the third time I'm washing it. I just want to show you this. I have already washed twice before. So after adding all the grated potato into it, add 1 liter of drinking water on top of it just for cleaning, because if you do this, you will remove all the starch from the potatoes. You know, potatoes are very starchy, so you need to remove all that. So this is the third time I'm washing it. So see, after washing it properly with the water, your potato should be dry. And also see, this is the third time I washed it and the water like this. The second time when I washed, see, it's a little bit of pinkish and bubbly. And the first time when you wash it, it will be completely bubbly. So remember how often you wash it. Once your water is clear, that is the indication that starch is being removed from your potato. After straining properly without any water, add into the mixing bowl again. See, it should be dry enough. It should not be watery, or it should not be in a paste like consistency. If that will be, see, this should be like strands or thread like. So then you need to add 2 tablespoons of corn flour. You need to check the consistency. For me, two tablespoons of corn flour was enough, but if you require more, just check it and then you can add it. Then add all-purpose flour or maida. Here I have added first 4 tablespoons of maida. And then you should give it a nice mix. Remember, do not mix with hand. I have also added salt to taste, almost 3/4 spoon for 8 potatoes, that is required. So do not mix it with hand. If you mix it with hand, again I told you, the starch from the potatoes, it will lose out and it will become a paste. So do not do that mistake. Just gently give it a nice mix with forks like this, as I have taken over here. Just give it a nice stir enough, that is enough. But don't dig in with the forks also. Don't dig it and it will become a paste again. So see, after having that, I just want to show you this. See, it's still watery. So that is not enough for us to prepare this hash brown. So again, I added 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour. Remember, only all-purpose flour. I didn't add corn flour again. So again, give it a nice gentle mix. So once I'm done with the mixing, I need to prepare the hash brown. So see here, this should be the consistency. But when you again start preparing it, water will be using out along with this all-purpose flour and corn flour. So just gently, see, as I have done here, in between your hands, just squeeze it gently so that all the water comes out. So that's it. Now you can take a cutter or something, otherwise you can do it on a kitchen platform also. So gently dab on top of it. Here I have used this to make all the sides even and also to keep all the potato strands intact. So it takes some time, but with patience if you do it, you will truly enjoy the output out of it. If you don't have this at home, you can also do with a spatula, with the dosa, how we remove it, with that also you can do it, or a long knife you can do this. So after having all the sides in an even shape, just take a knife and just cut it horizontally and vertically. Now see, take a piece and see, you just can see. We have added enough corn flour and maida so that it keeps all the potato strands intact, you know, like combined together. So that's it. Now just take it into your palm and just make even edges. See, this is the original hash brown shape and all. So take a pan and now you need to shallow fry this. Add just little bit of oil just for a shallow fry. So here I have added 3/4 of a cup of oil, that will be enough. So after 3 minutes on medium flame, this will be the texture. So after 3 minutes, just turn it around and then see, your hash brown is all ready. So now serve this with ketchup, and here see, I have served this with Amul cheese spread. So let me tell you, this hash brown is a famous breakfast recipe, McDonald's breakfast recipe. This my husband has taught me. He's been to Australia, and when he was there, he used to enjoy this hash brown for breakfast, and then we have given a trial, and truly all our family loved it. So we often make this. So I thought to share this with you all, because simple potato, this, that's it, and then that makes a very good dish out of it. So you too try it. See, your texture in the middle should be like this. So you too try it and enjoy, and let me know how it turned to you. Bye bye.